If you're in college and you're writing research papers, then you're most likely basing your formatting on this, the MLA Handbook for Writers of Research Papers. Now, when I say research papers, I mainly mean papers for English comp, literature, history, political science. Other papers might use other handbooks like the APA or Chicago, but the MLA is probably the most common, and it turns out it's very easy to adhere to this handbook when you use Microsoft Word. So let me show you how. And here we're at the start screen, right, where it gives you all sorts of fun templates to choose from. I'm going to search for the keyword MLA and then press enter. And here we go. We have the MLA style research paper, okay? I'm going to open that up in just a second. There's also the APA in here, okay? It's also helpful if you need to use, if your professor wants you to use that guideline or that handbook. But the MLA is the one we're going to use today. I'm going to double click that guy and open it. And this is just a template, right? You've probably made templates before. You know, select fields and fill them out. Okay, put my course number in here. English, comp, position, 100. Now look, I made a spelling mistake. Actually, when I asked a bunch of college professors what their biggest pet peeves were, surprisingly, the number one thing was students aren't using spell check. You know, so if you see a red squiggle, right-click that guy and replace it with the correct spelling. The other thing about spell check was people are using it, but not being careful in replacing words, you know, suggested words with the right word. So use spell check and use it carefully. Okay, enough of that lecture. The date, you can go ahead and you can choose this little content control arrow here and choose the due date. And this date is automatically formatted in the MLA style. So there's the day first, the month, and then the year, okay? That little automation for you happens throughout this template. It's great. For example, you've got a 1-inch margin on the left, which is what the MLA specifies as should be your left margin. You've got a 1-inch margin on the right. You've got a 1-inch margin on the top. You've got a 1/2-inch margin here before your header. Okay, this is all like just pretty much pre-built for you and ready for you to use. Okay, there's no need to type this out manually and build all these margins manually. And then the template has all sorts of awesome instructions for particulars of your paper. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and type in a title here of Zombies in American Fiction. Okay, I'll get rid of the subtitle, I don't really need that. And so just go ahead and read the instructions. Capitalize the first and last words of the title and all principal words. One way I like to do this quickly is I'll select a line, I'll do Shift F3 until I get the initial caps for every word, and then I'll go through here and I'll uncap the non-principal words here, the conjunctions and the prepositions. Okay, there we go. So use this template. It's a real boon, it's a real treasure, okay? If you keep on going through here, it'll give you more particulars, like for quotes of more than 4 lines, use the quote style up here. Okay, for long quotes of more than 1 paragraph, let's say there's a really long quote and it's 2 paragraphs or 3 paragraphs, you use the long quote style, okay? It's really good stuff. You've got a pre-made table here that has all the formatting that the MLA recommends, and you've even got things like this chart and a caption here, which is helpful, right, with a figure number. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and go back up here. Now, when you first start a paper, you probably shouldn't get, you know, start drafting right away, right? You probably need to outline, organize your thoughts, and some people do that with Post-it notes, some people do that with various other programs, maybe OneNote. You can do it here in this template, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna put a page break in there and then just show you how to outline here. If you need to outline in this template, click the no indent style and then multi-level list button, and then there's a special style in here called the MLA outline, right? Here's that classic outline structure of Roman numeral, uppercase letter, one period, little a, right? And you select that guy, and you can go ahead and outline your paper. You know, introduction, body conclusion, right? The second pet peeve of the professors that I polled, they said students just write sometimes. They just do a big mind dump. They don't really have this classic structure of introduction, body, conclusion, okay? So use an outline. Help yourself out in that regard, okay? It'll keep that structure enforced for you. Okay, when you add other lines, you just hit an enter like you would in any kind of list in Word, and then you can indent and get that A, right? And so maybe this is the opening sentence about zombies, build the case that zombies are strong in numbers, talk about herd mentality, I don't know. And then your thesis statement is here. Okay, so you can use these indent buttons, right? And get that further level of detail, get those parentheses around the number or use the little A, okay? This is nice because if you need to hand in an outline to your professor, it's in the MLA format. It's all kosher and ready to go, all right? There's also outline view, right, up here, view tab, outline. Okay, that works too, but if you gave that to your professor, they may not quite know to go in an outline view, so it may not be, you know, quite what they're used to seeing. So for an outline you need to turn in, this is a good way to go. Okay, when you need to actually replace this outline content with real written text, you could just type over it, right? I'm going to just pretend as if I did that and paste in this paragraph here. When you're ready to convert this list item here into a real honest to goodness MLA paragraph, you just choose the normal style, okay? And boom, paragraphs automatically formatted with MLA formatting. We've got that first line indent, we've got the double spacing, everything's great, okay? And you just keep going and typing and typing, replacing your outline content with that normal style, okay? Now, what's something else we do in Word that can help us with college papers? Citations and bibliographies, okay? This is a big time saver. If you're typing out that bibliography by hand, you should probably stop. It's probably just a big waste of your time, and you'll see why, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and open up this quotes document here, okay? And I got a couple citations from various sources. Fictional sources, of course, but sources nonetheless. And of course, when you cite something in a paper, you need to do it in a certain fashion that's kosher to the handbook you're using, either APA, Chicago, or MLA. We're using MLA, so what we're going to do is we're going to go up here to the References tab, and this is our little hub or center of citations and bibliographies. You're going to be here a lot, okay, when you're towards the end of your paper and you're adding all your citations and stuff. So we'll insert a citation, we'll choose new source. We're gonna first add a book to this, okay? And the book's gonna be by a guy named Scott Schriever. Okay, the title is Zombies Conquer. The year is 2006. The city's Seattle, city that it was published in Seattle. The publisher is AdventureWorks Press. Fix that little D there, okay? And the medium's print. Click okay. And the only thing that shows up is the author name, but that's okay because later when we generate the bibliography, it's gonna do it for us. It's gonna take all the information that we entered in there and format it for us. I'll show you that in a second. Now, since Scott's name is mentioned in the prose here, we don't need to cite his last name here, so we'll edit the citation. Okay, we do need to say which page number this quote comes from in the book, so we'll put that in. But we don't need the author in this particular citation, okay, because he's mentioned. So we'll suppress all that stuff, click OK, and there, that's a properly formatted citation for MLA. The other thing you got to remember to do is put your period on the outside of that citation. That's the right way to do it. Okay, and we'll go down, let's say we're at the last page of the document, and we'll go ahead and insert that bibliography. Works Cited is the one you'll use for MLA, so we'll go ahead and choose that. And here we go, we've got, you know, his name, last name first. We've got the italics for the book. We've got the city plus the colon, the publisher, the comma, the year, the period, print, period. There's all those periods, all those commas, all those colons, italics. I don't know about you, but when I'm writing a paper, I would rather concentrate on the actual content, the meat, the argument, than the periods and of a bibliography or the little fussy formatting. So Word can do that for you. Let it do that. Don't type that out by yourself manually. That is not a good use of your time. Let's do a scholarly journal citation here, okay? We'll go to insert caption, new source, and we'll insert a journal article. The author for this one is Alfredo Bosley, and the title is Zombies Are Alive and Well. Journal name is Adventure Works Scholars and Academics, and the year is 2003, pages. I know this is kind of boring, but it'll pay off in a moment. Pages 10 through 15, and the medium's print. Okay, great. Click OK. Okay, we'll see that all that information generated in the bibliography in a second. We do need the author name because it's not listed in the previous content, and we also need the page number. So we'll go ahead and push 11 in there, and we'll suppress the year and title. We don't need those for this particular handbook. APA and the sciences, they often need years, dates, so that your research is more recent, okay? And there we go, we've got that citation. Perfect, and now we'll generate a bibliography entry here. Okay, and we'll, by updating the bibliography, it'll look at all of our sources we've entered so far and generate entries for them. And there you go, you've got that. Name of the article in quotes, the italics for the journal, the year in parentheses, the colon, okay? All these little fussy things are done for you. You've also got that hanging indent. Word, it does really good bibliographies. I'm gonna show you the finished version of this bibliography here, okay? We've got all these entries perfectly formatted for us, okay? And if you ever need to update your sources, go back to that little center of citations and bibliographies and click Manage Sources. And that's where you can go ahead and make changes to the sources you've already entered, okay? This particular one here, you'll note that I have more than one name, okay? And it formatted those names for me. You know, last name first, and then the other name here, okay? Really handy stuff. In this particular case, I put Kindle file because I use the electronic or the non-print version of the book. That's where you would do that if you were using a non-printed material, okay? So that about wraps up our webinar today for tips on college papers in Microsoft Word. If you need more information about what we talked about today, maybe you need some articles to step you through these procedures a little more slowly. I kind of went through in a rapid fire fashion. You can do that by following those links at aka.ms/term123. We also have the links to the templates, both MLA and APA, there at the bottom. So check those out. There's no reason why you shouldn't be using those templates. They're really big time savers. So check those out. And for more information about our webinar series, aka.ms/offweb for our upcoming calendar and just general information about the series. Next week, we're going to be talking about Office 365 for nonprofits. And very special thanks to everyone in the room today, Ron, Doug, Bruce, Chris, Stephanie, who came to help us out. And come join us next week and stick around for the Q&A if you have any questions. Thanks.